Well, here's the cabinet, it's the finished product, the video's coming. I'm really glad that it's finished now. It's a fairly big job, and I'm really pleased to say also this video is sponsored by Masso CNC Controllers. Thank you, Masso. This is one of those jigs that I should have made years ago. For this job, I made this router jig that has this guide, just made out of wood, so it gives me exact dimensions between dados when I cut them, and just saved me having to measure everything out, and it worked perfectly. I just wanted to explain that I used hoop pine. This is 9mm hoop pine, and I had a lot of trouble with it, quite frankly, that it was cupping and bowing all over the place, and I had to fight it basically to make the cabinet sections and clamp it and glue it. I got a little bit impatient at times, and some of the glue joints broke. I ended up resorting to using nails, and it just took a lot longer than I anticipated, but in the end I got there with just a bit of patience. You can see there, it's just not straight. So part of the plan to try and solve this problem is to use these little silicon bronze nails, little tiny, I think they're 2mm, and tap those into the joint so they hold fast. So the upper cabinets are all completed now. This next part of the video just shows me building the lower parts of the cabinet, the lower section, and really it's much the same.
Come on. That's better.
It's not so bad, it's pretty good, but I have
And there might have been a few eagle eyes out there that noticed that I put the wheels so the whole thing couldn't cast, but I was just off camera fixed that.
We had to go and cut out all the drawers out of the plywood. So how I do that is I work out all the sections that I need on a sheet of plywood, one sheet. And that helps me maximize the use of the plywood.
So I decided to use finger joints. I'm using the finger joint jig here, or box jig. I really need to get a wider blade, a dado set or something like that for this. I ended up using the 2.7 millimeter, 3 millimeter blade, and it ends up, you just do like thousands of cuts, and it got very tedious in the end. It all worked out in the end, but there's a lot quicker ways of doing things. I really come up with some harebrained ideas sometimes. So I just wipe everything down with a bit of methylated spirits, and then I mask off bits and pieces that I don't want painted.
Get that on camera?
I did.
So good. Nice safeties.
You like?
Mm. Remember, so, to get the best tools, doubledwoodtools.com.
Always on the cell.
Yep. So I've got three boards that are a darker colour and three boards that are a lighter colour. So I've got to try and match and work out what's best. If you don't have a jointer, you can always use a hand plane to get your boards parallel to each other. Off camera, glued the two cabinet halves together. Just showing a little trick here that Joel from Studio Dubell taught me. Just get some water, wet down the your job, and that what that does is just raises the grain. Then come back when it's dry and sand those raised grains off. Then that helps just speed the process up when you're applying finish. And another thing, these cabinet end panels help lock all the cabinets together into the steel frame once they're glued in. Next step is to put some trim around all these parts here before I go and put the fascias on the drawers.
Perfecto! Mwah! Mwah!
Just doing my best to keep these all matched up.
So I had a little change of plans. Originally I wanted to have the drawers flush with the trim panels, with the trim bits, but I decided it looks better with the drawer sticking out just a little bit.
I'm massaging the thing. So this is the next day after applying the Tung oil.
These are going to be my handles.
I just made a simple jig that helps me find the center of the drawer panel so I can drill the holes for the drawer knobs. This might even be the sexiest thing I've built yet. Alright, that's the end. That concludes the video. I hope everybody enjoyed the video. I'd really love to see you in the comments and let me know your thoughts on that there. And hopefully, if you like the video, give me a thumbs up. And I'll see you next time. Thank you.